I'm Susan Jackson, and I do like tuna. I'm the president of the International Seafood Sustainability Foundation, which is a foundation, a nonprofit foundation that's a partnership with tuna scientists, tuna processing industry, and World Wildlife Fund and other NGOs. In 2010, only about 12% of the boats had a tracking number that stayed with that boat. The RFMOs are requiring them to have it now. Today, over 88% of the large-scale fishing boats have that tracking number, and that allows us to know if a boat has done something illegal. They can't just change their name or change their flag or change their color or move to another part of the world, and then nobody knows their history. Captains of purse seine fishing vessels were using old netting to create fish aggregating devices that they used to fish on. Researchers discovered that that old netting that was hanging underneath those would entangle other marine life and entangle sharks. So once the researchers discovered this question of the problem of the entanglement, they developed a solution, which is stop using nets, use ropes, use fabric. And that solution we started telling the boat captains about a year or two ago. And now three of the four RFMOs are also requiring that the fish aggregating devices used in their region not include netting so that this problem of entanglement has been eliminated. ISSF now has a program where individual vessels can sign up for auditing and transparent verification that they're participating in the most sustainable practices for their gear type. What's exciting is now retailers around the world are starting to ask for tuna that comes from boats or is caught by boats that have registered with the PBR, recognizing the responsible steps that they're taking by agreeing to be part of this program. In order for tuna fisheries to be effectively managed, that means the regional fisheries management organizations should be adopting the recommendations of their scientific bodies. And then all those member countries need to go back to their country and pass laws and enforce laws implementing those measures that they've agreed to. So it's a question, first of all, of political will at the international level to implement the scientific advice. And then it's a question of political will, capacity, enforcement, and regulation at the national level to make sure that it's actually happening. Tuna have biology on their side. They reproduce very quickly, but biology and luck is not a management strategy. ISSF's goal is to go out of business because we want tuna fisheries to be effectively managed by governments and regional fisheries management organizations. But we're here to help them get to that point, and we'll know that it's time to go out of business when the tuna stocks are healthy, when there are rules and reference points in place for all of them under the management system so that they will stay healthy. When the environmental interaction or ecosystem impact of tuna fishing has been minimized to an appropriate level, then our work is done.